My name is Aaron Sumrall. I'm a county extension agent for Texas AgriLife Extension for the part of the A&M University system. Right now, currently in San Jacinto County, and I'm also a PhD candidate at Texas A&M University in College Station. All right, any part of any trapping setup, the first part you need to think about is you need to think about the camera location. You need to know what the size of the sounders are that you're working with. You need to know the size of the individuals in that sounder. And also you need to know, the main thing is you need to know what your non-target species considerations are. Using cameras in your trap set locations will be able to give you that idea, tell you what your volume is of the sounders you're working with, in addition to that, the populations of non-targets. The cameras will always give you other informations that you'll need to know, such as post spacing in your traps. The larger the animals in the sounders, you probably want to get your post a little tighter spaced. If you have smaller animals, you may be able to get away with a little bit wider spacing, but never going above 4 foot in your spacing on your post in your traps. But the primary focus of using the cameras in the traps is most opinions is going to be to establish the size of the sounders you're working with and the non-target species that you're trying to trap around or to avoid.